Today we discuss updates on the Brazilian voluntary disclosure program. Simoes, what happened with our Brazilian clients who did the program and disclosed their assets, and what happened with the clients who preferred to not disclose the assets and to keep the assets still secret? Are these assets, these offshore assets, these offshore bank accounts, will they remain secret, or what happened? What happened? What are the latest developments? Tell us about. Thank you.
The latest developments, the latest updates. In 2019, there are a lot of updates. So regarding Brazilians who did declare their assets, we have clients that did this with us, and they followed the law by the book. And now the Brazilian fiscal authorities changed the law, and they are creating some kinds of phishing expeditions, phishing procedures, and sending letters to these Brazilians who did participate in the program, asking them to show the origin of the money. And this is forbidden by our constitution, by our law. So if you are in this place, if something like this happens to you, the best way to solve this problem is to contact a team of international lawyers who will give you the protection in Brazil and also internationally.
In Switzerland, for example, where the account is. Yeah. In Luxembourg, wherever.
Luxembourg, whatever. So this is what happened with clients who did declare.
But that's very bad. That's very bad.
That's
so
very
the
bad.
Client trusted. He trusted, you know, he trusted to the government. Mm-hmm. And now what happened? His trust was misused by the government.
Perfect. That's the
unbelievable. That's unbelievable.
Yeah, that's Brazil, unfortunately.
So that's why you need lawyers to make the protection of your assets, of the declaration that you did. Maybe you didn't declare the money with us. Then you could reach us, and then we're going to see the protection that we could do for this phishing expeditions of our fiscal authorities.
So you represent these clients with the Brazilian tax authorities, so on a case-by-case basis. You are negotiating a solution on a case-by-case
mm-hmm.
basis.
That's
basically
it.
Because some of the clients, they already received those letters, and we have some procedures against the fiscal authorities because they are not allowed to do this. So we can protect these clients who did declare. It's not the majority of them, just a few of them that had this kind of problems. But if you have a problem similar to this, we can protect you through some measures, judicial measures, because it's totally against the law.
Thank
really
you.
Important.
Thank you very much. And what solutions do you recommend for people who did not file for HERCT, who has not legalized offshore assets? What they should do? Because now we have a common reporting standard. We have the automatic exchange of information. So there is a lot exchange of information. So it's quite a risk. This money, these accounts will be disclosed sooner or later. What do you recommend to these guys? What should they do?
Perfect answer. So I just said that people who did participate in the program are facing some fears regarding the Brazilian fiscal authorities. But it's even worse for the people who didn't participate in the region. Why? Because their assets will be disclosed. As Enzo just told us, CRS is coming.
For sure.
So the Brazilian fiscal authorities will have the data of those accounts. And sometimes we still receive clients asking us, well, what should we do? We have the solution. We can declare the past through rectification of the declaration in Brazil, or through some other procedures like inheritance proceeding. It's a case-by-case scenario that we need to study.
Case by case, very
but
important.
we can give the solution for those problems. But it's really important, Enzo.
Yeah.
CRS is in place.
It's coming. It's not like, you know, in other times we had some fiscal changes when the law changes. There we had always solution to circumvent this law, but the automatic exchange of information, the CRS, there is no special solution. It will come 100%. There is no escape. I don't see escape, honestly spoken. I don't see escape
Me
from
neither.
This.
Yeah.
You have to go the legal way. You have to go according to the books. You have to follow the legal way, because Swiss banks are very scared to protect Brazilian clients. They will not protect you because they are scared for the Brazilian government for fines. Because what happened? The United States of America fined Swiss banks with billions, billions of money. They extorted Swiss banks. Now we had in February, we had another decision from the French court in Paris, fine against UBS of 5 billion. Italy also in March, just 1 month ago, sent 160 letters to European offshore banks asking Swiss banks for procedure, for questions. So the automatic exchange of information, CRS, this will come for sure. You need to be prepared. Otherwise, you are going to be criminalized 100%. So take care. Better taking care before than after when you are in the mess.
And this is a very honest opinion because Enzo is a specialist in Swiss banking accounts. And also, I just finished my postdoctoral degree in Brazil. I'm finishing my postdoctoral degree at IBFD in Amsterdam. And we can assure you, if you didn't declare those assets, you will be discovered. So the sooner you act, the sooner you start taking reactions of this reality, it's better for you, it's better for your assets.
So you should legalize your assets because there is no shortcut and there is no free lunch. In case you want to discuss this very sophisticated topic with us, give us a call. We will consider, we will sit together and discuss your situation, your specific situation on a case-by-case basis. Call us, take your mobile phone in your hands and call us now on 0041-442-124404. Thank you very much for your attention. Be rich and remain rich. Have a wonderful day.